Alright guys, so you've almost made it to the end. This is the final lecture video in your video series for week one. So let's talk about some more examples of domesticated companions. Most animals that have been domesticated are mammals. However, some birds and fish have also been domesticated. This list is certainly not exhaustive. If you have a favorite companion animal we have not discussed, I encourage you to look up their domestication history and whether or not they have been fully domesticated. So what are some of the effects of domestication? What differs between a wild animal and its domesticated counterpart? Pedomorphosis, also known as neoteny, is the retention of juvenile characteristics into adulthood. This can include large head and eyes, floppy or oversized ears, playfulness, and vocalizations. Another effect of domestication is an increase in coat color variation. Coat color is affected by the amount of adrenaline and cortisol an animal produces. Melanin, which controls pigment production in fur, may share a biochemical pathway with adrenaline. A domesticated animal produces less adrenaline and cortisol, so they have a wider variety of coat colors than wild animals. It's also theorized that people really liked the unique colors that popped up when animals began being domesticated, so people probably also encouraged some of the unique coloration. One of the most detrimental effects of domestication, as far as our companion animals are concerned, is that domesticated animals are very efficient at reproducing, much more so than their progenitors. Out of all the hallmarks of domestication, this one certainly has the largest impact on animal welfare. Thousands of companion animals are homeless due to their overwhelming ability to procreate, and thousands more are euthanized in shelters every year. So thank you guys for tuning in to this week's lesson on domestication. Make sure to keep on top of your due dates, and good luck in all your studies.